Good morning, dear colleagues. I will speak about clinical and statistical grouping in oncology. The statistics has already a long tradition in the Russian Federation, and we cover more and more provinces and areas in Russia with our statistic analysis. However, in cancer therapy, we now apply a comprehensive approach involving also systemic medical aid. I cannot say that we are without any hitches in this development, but we've been allocated 6 years for doing this according to our program. And I would like to start with describing the whole system. The presidential decree ran like that to introduce new statistical accounting of the treatment methods to provide for better insurance coverage of the patients. Before, we used to analyze the medical aid throughout the whole country, and we applied the average figures to the development of planned indicators for our insurance system everywhere in the country. However, today we've had a number of events which influenced the traditional method of arranging for the insurance coverage. We have better legal paperwork. There have been amendments to the standards, to the guidelines for medical aid. Now we have another tool. We have a set of criteria for the quality of medical aid, which will be in force as of the 1st of January 2022. The same goes for various kinds of paying for medical aid. In order to make this process practical, we had to make amendments to quite a number of legal paperwork, beginning with the law number 323. There were various memos from the Ministry of Healthcare. There were guidebooks for the compulsory medical insurance, also reference books, which where the provisions have already become legally binding. I don't think I will be able to speak about all of these amendments because the system as a whole, it spread, but it was both expanding and deepening. The first thing which we have already started to work on, this and a lot will depend on it, These are clinical guidelines for treatment, which are supposed to be prepared by the council and the Ministry of Healthcare, using the principles of modern medicine. And we think that as early as this month, the clinical guidelines for cancer treatment will be already in force for the whole country. Of course, the quality of these guidelines will be discussed, but we've got to do that so that we would be able to work more efficiently. The second paper, which is very important, is the government program of healthcare guarantees. For the first time, the government, the state, has singled out cancer treatment, allocating 76,000 rubles for help, medical aid in case of cancers and treatment. We understand that practically every patient will receive this allotment, and that is, of course, much better financing added to what we used to have. We'll have also 20 billion rubles more, which are planned for 2021. It will be difficult to make use of this money, but after some time, we'll undoubtedly think that this money are also insufficient for all the needs of treatment of cancer diseases. Another very important thing is the issue of compulsory medical insurance. These means are not the only source of financing, because, for instance, drugs, medicines, they are financed via quite a number of sources of finance, but we don't yet have exact rules for allocating treatment to many patients, whether they need an outpatient treatment or hospital treatment. However, at least there is an understanding that if the drug has got to be administered at the hospital, we've got to apply it at the hospital with the full-scale hospital care for the patient. The patient should not have any problem with getting to the hospital for the drug to be administered at the hospital. If it is a preferential drug that has been allocated for the patient on the privileged program of treatment for oncological patient, the patient should also be able to go to the hospital to receive the drug. Another issue is around-the-clock surveillance of the patient, medical surveillance, if the treatment is applied around the clock. If the patient doesn't need around-the-clock medical attention, then we can send the said patient to the outpatient clinic, or, as an exception, to free him of medical attention, but only for a very short period of time, because any case of administering treatment should be individually discussed. Maybe later there will be amendments to this arrangement, but as of now, it is like that. Another standard. What does this standard include? Unfortunately, this standard doesn't include hematological diseases in oncology. It covers only tumors, because diseases, oncological diseases of the blood, they are categorized under a different heading. And if we start now changing the pattern, it may be that we just won't find money in time to take care of these patients. So now we'll go over to our interactive procedure of voting. Please start the voting. We'll have now to vote, and we have 20 minutes to do this. So the software for voting has been launched, and we have, you know, baseline rate of funding. Our question: how does this rate of financing, how is this financing rate established? On the federal, regional level, or on the regional level, but according to the federally approved methods? Has everybody given their votes? Yes, and the answer was right. It is the tariff rate, funding rate, is approved on the regional level, but it is determined on the federal level as of 2090. All these amendments to the legislation were made in order to improve the situation in cancer treatment. And that's why the federal government disavowed all the tariff agreements of the provinces. And now we have, on the federal level, we have set the minimum rate of funding, the threshold rate, in the amount of 60%. The standard, besides medical aid, includes high-tech services, mutual reconciliation between different actors, But this has been done to provide for the stable medical care of the patients. Also, the same order sets the limits for all factors or coefficients which can be applied for the calculation of funding of healthcare. So now the finances in the provinces are under very strict government control by the central government. These standards have been calculated based on the clinical guidelines. They have not yet been approved in full according to the new law. However, the approved clinical guidelines were, of course, taken into account. And now we have quite a number of standards for surgical treatment, for conservative treatment with medications, for replacement of catheters and medical equipment. Practically the whole set of procedures applied by the cancer wards is covered by this order with separate items of budget singled out. Each group of therapeutic procedures has a code of its own, and so it can be sorted out in full compliance with the legislation. We used this principle for cases when there is a break between applications of medicine of at least 5 to 6 days. If the patient is at hospital within the first 20 days of treatment, and the treatment is applied on the first 8th, 15th, and so on, this, we now think it expedient to put the patient on the hospital bed immediately. If there is an intermittent character of administering treatment, the treatment can be paid for according to a different procedure, according to the pattern number one. We cover 2 days of administering the treatment, and for other arrangements, 1 day of treatment is covered. So I will appeal to you, please be so kind to read carefully the methodical guidelines for the treatment. And the next group, if we take radiation therapy, for instance, with us, we sort it by 2 indicators, the kind of the therapy and the number of fractions. If we also join chemotherapy to that, then the logic is as follows. If chemotherapy is more expensive than radiation therapy, then we start with, we determine the cost in accordance with the cost of the medication. If radiation therapy, radiotherapy is more expensive, then we take our bearings from its cost. That's how the therapy is sorted out, trying to take into account both the logic for radiotherapy and for chemotherapy at once. Here you won't see any doses of radiation, nor times when it should be administered, only general guidelines. And it was found out that if we try to make it more detailed, it would be much more difficult to calculate the cost of the course of treatment as a whole. That's why this approach was chosen. And with a very great probability, this table will be just like the previous one, which includes even the patterns of administering drugs. This is how it works in our grouping file. This file is not very easy to run. However, we have a certain pattern for using this or that medicine, and it can be applied in any case where the cost of the drug is higher than that of the radiotherapy. This standard, it works because we have a list of medical services rendered to the patient. However, we still have to work at it because one and the same surgical operation can be called differently by different surgeons. But now we have an order from the Ministry of Healthcare that we have to apply only the names that run standard for the medical colleges and the universities. Of course, there will be difficulties and might be mistakes in reporting and statistical accounting associated with the change in the lists and inventories. However, the next problem that we have is protection of the patient with tumors. For the patient which we have to treat using several types of treatment for neoplasms, then we must use a special coefficient which is supposed to increase the amounts allocated for the treatment of the cancer patient. You know that quite a number of drugs, especially those that are not included in the list of vital drugs, we could not buy them on the insurance money. But today, all the drugs that can be used for adjuvant therapy, they are now included. In case when we have to replace or install a new subsystem during chemotherapy or before surgery, we now have it covered by the compulsory medical insurance as well. And there was an exception specifically for cancer patients. The main principle for grouping the patients is a specific treatment of that group, because financing can either go up in accordance with the group rate or down. This is again another rule that can be used in the regions. And now we have the second question to vote on. We'll now put it on the screen here. Have you started the second voting? Because I do not see it here on my phone. Just a moment. Now we have the window for voting. Can we see it also on the screen? Now we see it on the screen.
I'm going. Okay, I would let the audience vote, and then I will comment the voting result. If in the framework of one hospitalization, one or more regimens are given, how can we calculate the reimbursement? And the multiple answer questions. Okay. Have you managed to vote? Are you voting in the audience? Colleagues, as a matter of time, it's a tricky question. It's a revenge. Our revenge to you, clinicians. You know, you usually answer, okay, you know, our patient is an individual. But you know, the majority, in fact, responded as follows. Complexity coefficient of patient, of course, if clinical guidelines imply that. But basically, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Indeed, these five clauses imply two regimens to be given to a patient. And we recommend, indeed, in our newsletters to use this coefficient. Okay, I would like to have voting results on the screen. Other regimens. Basically, no one voted for that, even though that's the most common situation in practice. When, you know, the combination that is not listed in clinical guidelines is prescribed. As a matter of fact, it's prohibited. Of course, we would like to be reimbursed according to the most expensive regimen. But coefficient, complexity coefficient should be established first. And as long as it's not established, so reimbursement should be calculated in accordance with the most expensive regimen. And you know, the territorial mandatory insurance funds are transferring the fund. Another option, the management coefficient, but it's also set up. It's also an option. That's why the correct answer sir. It should be resolved at the regional level. There is no universal approach. Colleagues, probably I'm done. I'm not sure whether it was apprehended. Thank you very much for your brilliant presentation. We're able to take just one question. Just one question. Inna, thank you very much for your wonderful explanation. I have a question. Sometimes the coefficient is lower than 1, like 0.9. No, it cannot be the case for cancer dispensary. No, it's a violation. No, this coefficient cannot be lower than 1. Oncology dispensary, 0.9. And what about the level of an organization? You have no license. No, as a matter of fact, I can accept that. Please open my presentation. I don't remember threshold value for level 2. Unfortunately, indeed. Theoretically, it can be the case. But please understand. No matter what the coefficient is, you know, reimbursement would be almost the same. They are the regions that cannot get less. And we applied all these factors, all the highest factors in the region. And as a result, the basic level remained at 4,000. Level 1 organization, I have 0.7 factor. But everything depends on overall resources. You know, one coefficient doesn't make a big difference. But again, the organization should not be discriminated. Thank you very much.